WFM. Hey, move and to inspire and to break the culture of silence. Here is 91.7, the voice of women, the voice of women, the voice of women, 91.7. The voice of women, the voice of women, the voice of women, 91.7 WFM. 91.7.
Almana Hope Foundation,
in partnership with
Women Radio 91.7, brings you
A Widow's Window,
where issues affecting widows in our society are discussed. Join Hope Nwakwesi
Saturdays, 6 p.m.
On WFM 91.7. A Widow's Window, giving widows.
So you're standing in the middle of the thunder and lightning. I know you're feeling like you just can't win, but you're trying. It's hard to keep on keeping on when you're being pushed around. Don't even know which way is up. Just keep spinning down, around, down. Every storm runs out of rain, just like every dark night turns into day. Every heartache will fade away, just like every storm runs out of rain. So hold your head up and tell yourself that there's something more, and walk out that door. Go find a new rose, don't be afraid of the thorns, cause we all have thorns. Just put your feet up to the edge, put your face in the wind. And when you fall back down, keep on remembering.
Hey, good evening, another beautiful weekend, and this is a beautiful Saturday. You're on the show A Widow's Window, time check, 3 minutes past the hour, 6 p.m., and this is The Widow's Window. Our silence has remained a veil on widowhood, and the time has come for us to cut the cord so as to unveil the hood. It takes a voice to get the voices that makes the change. Once again, this is The Widow's Window, A Widow's Window, the Nigerian first family radio talk show with widows. Now we talk about widowhood inside out. My name still remains Stella David Moyem. And, I'm standing in for Lady Hope. I hope she joins us on Facebook. Yes. We are still on Widow's Window. We started this year with the series Widows 101. I will tell you that it's like every day, should I say we are welcome to the wood or men to the wood? No, I don't welcome them. I will just tell them this is the wood. The truth is that it's on the increase. And for us, we are broadcasting live from WFM 91.7 Women's Radio. And we're streaming live on FM, on Facebook, WFM 91.7, and also on YouTube. But on the studio, you could join us with the conversation on 07000-917-917, or you text 07030-17-565-37. We're streaming live, A Widow's Window. And we have a very, 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 very interesting topic today. Yes, Madam Hope, I know she will join us one way or the other. But I will tell us, last week we talked about grief recovery methods, what to tell a widow and what not to tell a widow. Because when she is grieving or mourning, you know, at that time, she's up there, is a fog. She doesn't know what she's doing at that particular time. Some people will come and say, don't worry, that's how God wants it. This, that, that. No, 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 no. We don't need that. If you don't have anything, just keep short. Make eye contact. Do patting on the back and she will understand. At times, it's better to keep quiet than to open your mouth and don't worry, God knows how it is. God sees everything. In my mind, then I will say, why God not do your own? Why you can't do my own? Yes, yes, yes. You are joining us live once again on A Widow's Window. And today we're going to talk about taking charge of your association. Taking charge of your association. As a widow, we're going to talk to widows particularly today. And if you're a widow out there, you can still join us and you want to contribute or tell us how the widow should take charge of our association, still join us on 07000. Or let's see your comment on the comment box. Let's see your comment on the comment box as we are streaming live on Facebook this evening. Okay, take charge of your association. Yes. Some people have been in the wood for 17 years. At least I know of three people. Madam Hope has been there for 27 years. We are there for 5 years. Some people are still coming in. Some people are the day into it. Some people 25 days, 2 weeks into it. It doesn't matter how long you have been there. What really matters is your mindset and who is going on the journey with you. Who is going on the journey with you matters. Because as this general saying, birds of the same feather flock together. If somebody out there has not felt the pain, the person will not know what to tell you as you feel the pain. Okay. So I did some research and I looked at how do you take charge of how do you take charge of your association as a widow? The first thing I'll tell widows when they are in the wood, when they just come in, I'll just tell them to first and foremost forgive. Forgive the late man. Forgive as many things, because you will hear things. You will feel so dejected. People that were close will go away. Just the first thing to your healing, the first thing to associate yourself with is forgiveness. Open your heart and forgive. Forgive the man. Forgive the children. Forgive yourself. Forgive the people that came for burial and said things that they are not supposed to say. Okay, Madam Hope is online. Madam Hope, let's hear you. Good evening, Lady Hope.
Good evening, Lagos, and good evening, everybody.
Yeah.
Stella, well done. Yeah, the reality is that I would just be listening so that you continue. But I had what you said. The truth is that in order to move on, you know, last week we talked about grief and this thing.
Yeah.
So today, you know, in order to move on, you just have to forgive yourself.
Very true.
You just have to forgive everybody that is around you. You just have to know there is nothing that you could have done that you didn't do.
Mm.
If there was anything you could do, God would have made it. And, you know, there's this proverb in my place that says that if God is not aware, that is translated, it doesn't happen.
Mm.
So just go on and, you know, let me be.
Listen, you want to be a listening viewer. And I hope don't live there.
Yeah, I'll be contributing. But...
Okay. As I said, one of the ways to take charge of your association is to forgive. If you don't forgive yourself, you don't have that peace of mind. If you don't forgive the man, you will be cursing him even in grave. If you don't forgive the children, because one way you just said, you know, things happen. You know, the thinking, the mentality, the mindset. Why did this thing happen to me? With all my prayers, with all this, that, justifying yourself. But please, please forgive. During the burial, so many talks would have come. People would have said things. People would have reacted the way they didn't know. Take notes. As I always tell people, the other end, they are mourning a brother, they are mourning a cousin, they are mourning somebody, and you are mourning a husband, and the children mourning the father. So everybody has to forgive each other. That is the first thing.
Yeah, let me chip in something. There,
okay.
Because that's a big thing that we keep saying here. When families start to fight, they seem to they have not understand that each and every one of them are grieving. And there is no one that is grieving that his or her grieving is more.
Exactly.
Why the wife will say, yes, he's my husband, you know, do you know that? Come on, sweetheart, it's the mother.
Hmm.
That is the woman or the father. That is the parents bearing their children.
Child, yes.
It is their brother.
Ha.
You know.
They've stayed for years together. All of a sudden, the person is out. It's cut off.
There is no scale that can bring about the measurement of this grief to know who should respect
mourn
each
more.
Other in the grief.
Exactly.
So who should respect each other in the grief. They are all grieving equally.
Very true.
You just have to understand we are all grieving equally,
okay.
And understand that the only way to heal is to understand that we are all grieving at our own point.
Okay.
And then, you know, how do you now do the new association for yourself?
Yes, we're coming to that.
A new you.
Yes.
A new you.
And
that is right. A new you. The only way to understand it is to understand.
Very true.
This has happened. There's nothing you can do.
Mm-hmm.
It is nobody's fault. Even if you say, you know, sometimes, you know, this person was killed by the family or the power.
Of course.
Spiritual power. Even if you think it is that, just realize that, accept that if God wanted it to happen, God didn't want it to happen, it will not happen.
Very true.
So for it to happen, God wanted it to happen.
Okay.
And you may not have a reason to justify it. There's no reason that will give that will make it. But it has happened. The question is this. What do I do? You know, I said it in my book. Begin.
Yes.
And to begin.
Okay.
The only way and to begin. Is that his
end to begin.
Begin.
Okay.
And to begin. That's at every point. And the beautiful thing about this end to begin, I stress it more and I added it to even when you make mistake.
Very true. I'll come to that. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you, Lady Hope. I wish you are in the studio. Okay. There's another thing that came to my mind. After you have forgiven yourself, you have let go, because that's the part of your healing process. You ask yourself, because I always tell people, widowhood is just a status. You are still yourself in there. Deep in there, you are still yourself. You have to bring out the strength that made you to stand as a woman or as a man that has grieved, has lost a loved one. And that is where you ask yourself, what do I want to do now? Before you get to that level, we should know that widows and widowers, particularly widows, we tend to rely less on others at this time. That is where association comes to play. You know, when somebody is grieving, you don't take, for example, I made a lot of mistakes, especially in my financial decisions. I made a lot of mistakes. Because the money was there, I was like, okay, let me settle this debt. I always tell people, if you know you are not good in your you're not financially intelligent, get a professional. That's one association you should take charge of. Am I on track, Lady Hope? Because you find that when you have that money, maybe people are just like, oh, I will take care of this. Then immediately the barrier is where everybody goes their own. And it's what you have on hand. That is what you have to start with. If you don't have a good job, or if you don't have something that is bringing in money, even if you have a case, it's a case of two people's job that become one person's own. So one of the way to take care of your association, I am not financially intelligent. I need somebody that is good in it. I have a widow she owns a school. The husband was in charge of the finances, everything. When the man died, this lady, I said, sis, how are you going to do it? Luckily, she said, let her just close the school. I said, no, don't make the mistake I made by trying to do things by myself. No. Look for somebody, a good administrator and an accounting person. Do you know that those are part of association so that your money can keep growing? Your business can keep growing. Did you get it now? So when you take charge, when you have taken part of care of that one, another thing, like I have a story. There's this lady, we're very, very good friends. So when I lost, she lost her husband. Then she remarried like 2 years later. We lost the same year. She married like 2 years later. I didn't get remarried. Later, in a year in our marriage, I was just talking. Say, tell I feel like changing my circle of friends. I say, wow. You are changing. No wahala now. Indirectly, Stella, pack one side. So is you when you were talking about association, listen to who talks to you so that you can filter and know who wants you around. Because if somebody does not want you around, you find out that the person will tend to bring you sadness because the person will talk about things the person is not supposed to talk about. I have a case of a widow said she anytime she goes to our friends, the married friends, I'll say, my husband is coming around 6 o'clock. Oh, will you please just go? Later we'll see, babe. She will tell her before this, when they were married, she can stay till 8 o'clock and nobody's saying anything. Did you get it now?
Yeah.
Ah, so
the reality is this, can I come in?
Yes, come in, ma'am.
One of the things you do as a widow is to streamline your friends. And let me tell you a tip that will help you.
Okay.
What you ask yourself, those friends you have, how well are they helping to help you readjust to your new life?
How will help you readjust your new life?
Both in what they say, what they look,
exactly.
And how they look. Exactly. They are not telling you, I just finished it on before on Facebook. We say,
yeah.
I said, if the one of the way you the first thing, if we have that, if you're a widow, because you're emotionally down and you're mentally unstable and shaking, because I mean, when you're emotionally down, it's going to affect your mental well being, is not very accurate.
Very true.
And if you have a friend that is going to say, oh, I hope you know something. Hey, yeah, my husband just bought me a new car.
You can imagine, no?
Hey, my husband just bought me. If you do not know how to
undo yourself, exactly.
It is the time for me to just go inside house, not because you are envious.
No.
But because you just want to heal. Because he's not going to buy you
a car.
The one that will buy you.
Exactly.
Or the one that will now say to you, I don't know. I've been asking to. I've been telling Tony to do this on the bed for a long time. I don't know where he went. I mean, this I'm telling you a really life story that you hear people say that somebody's going to get. And he just, I don't know how he did that. He just did this last night to me.
You can imagine.
You don't need that detail.
At all. At all.
And like I said, because the reality is that when she's trying to adjust, her environment should help her to adjust. If you are a sister or a friend, you should be sensitive enough to help her readjust herself by streamlining diplomatically
exactly
what you present to her.
Yes,
I'm not saying if you're my friend and because I'm widowed, you're married, that we don't have to be friends.
No,
it's not. But I expect you to know that I have. So there are common things you can say discussing. About
yes, there's money, business one. That's my number one.
There's even family, children,
emotional aspect. Yes, parenting too.
There are so many things you can be discussing without putting, you know, direct husband affair inside it. But that doesn't mean that
you can still talk about it.
Exactly.
Like sorry for cutting you, Madam O.
Oh, yeah.
Like tell people, everybody has their grace. This one has the grace of, I'm still in my husband's house. I have the grace that, this man died. And everybody's grace will speak. Depends on how you carry it.
Yeah.
Because when you are, because truly, at that initial stage of marriage, I think what really affected me, I had to delete all, anybody that I see the husband and the wife dressed in the same attire. I will just cross. Oh my God.
No, and you were not doing it. That's part of what you are saying, you know, because it is your emotional state.
Yes, yes.
And nobody should blame you because you are confused. You're angry that you're
angry. I think that's the word, anger.
That's what it is.
Yeah.
You're angry that, and you just can't understand what is going on. So you're emotionally, you're unstable, and you can pick fight with the smallest thing.
Misinterpret
the
issues. Very true. Very true. Very true.
smallest thing. So the best bet at that time is, and that's one of the beautiful things of today's world. The today's world has given you an opportunity to have your life. You know, remember one of the widows that wrote her, and she said 3 months after her husband died, she was so confused, you know, she just came onto Facebook, Father Lord, order me to somebody that can mentor me. And then, like, sure, she just started me one night, and I called her, I said that morning she came to Lagos, we talked and everything. I said, look, and she was so happy because in that, through me, like you said, she met a whole lot of other widows. That
exactly. Now, feels, yeah, feels what she feels, and like, yeah.
So that's find your circle of friends.
Find your circle of friends. You know, even in widowhood, there's some circle of friends you must not go with.
Of course. No, when you're finding it, don't ever lose yourself.
Don't ever lose your hand. Because you'll find that, I still say it, even till this morning, till this evening, I was coming from the wedding. I was telling one widow, I said, widow is just a status. The real person is still the person. The only thing is that during the morning, the griefing, and going through responsibilities, you become tougher, you become harder. But
let me give you an example of how to describe widowhood. Because when people say that it's widowhood that makes a certain thing, I tell them that it's not true.
Yeah.
That you should look inward and see how you have addressed you.
Yes.
Because widow, a man that now comes in and look at you and says, Stella, you're a stupid man. He has not planned anything.
It's inside, of course.
He didn't have the audacity. The only thing that happened is this. Alcohol gave him the audacity.
Exactly.
So if I want to relate it in that, you mean, if some people will say, my husband died, they can't do it, you know, I mean, someone tapped me again today in the Facebook and said, since my husband died, I had 5 children. I don't know how many years ago. I can't remember how many years.
2018. I saw it. I didn't even respond.
Okay. I said, I have not gotten any help. And I said, what kind of help? Since my husband died, I have 4 children, I've not gotten any.
Okay, I think I answered that. I now said, how do you mean? He said, to help a widow. I said, mentality.
How do you, who is going to help?
That you must help a widow. It's from the Bible.
Nigeria. it shows, if this person is not doing this because she's a widow. She's doing it because it's her personality.
Very true.
You can't go and put on the Facebook or somebody you don't know that it's your husband, or you go and meet somebody you have not seen before. Says my husband died, I've not gotten any help from anybody.
See me. Okay? Oh, God, do.
You can't. Exactly.
Even I had, sorry for cutting, I had the story of this, where one widow, I think she stays in Abuja. Here she goes to every group. Any giveaway, she will put her name. Every group. They said they even gave her options of different jobs. She said, no, this one is too stressful. No, this one is too far from my house. No, I'm bigger than this job. But she goes to every widow's group, every single group, every matured group to ask for help. So that is the person. That is who she is, not the fact that she's a widow.
That is a lazy beggar.
It's a lazy beggar. Even beggar get great.
The reality is that I with all due respect, we're not mentioning, because there are billions, it's not only that one, there are billions of them like that. Wow. I mean, there are so many of them that are taking my money.
Wow.
They give me, I will want to do business, and they will buy my number.
Seriously.
So, but the reality is that that person is not better even as a wife.
Mm-hmm.
It wouldn't have been better even as a wife. Mm-hmm. So, the point is that who are you? Sit down and define who you are. What defines you? What do you want? So if you define what you want and know what you want and start with what you want.
Exactly.
You will get where you want.
You get to where you are going to. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
You will get to where you want to be.
Mm-hmm.
And one of the things is not by expecting and being entitled.
Entitlement
that
now.
Certain things are at your core because you are. I mean, there are so many married wives that are even poorer than widows.
Very true.
There are even so many married husbands that cannot even provide for their family. Those are even most of them 99.9% better. So nothing says that you have to be second-hand figure.
Mm.
except you. The society can say that, but it's only you that can accept that.
Thank God we are changing the narrative.
Yeah, if you don't accept it, if you do not accept it.
You have 1 minute remaining.
Okay. Madam Hope, I don't know if it's your own, it's 1 minute. Okay, thank you, ma'am. Yes, as I said earlier, one of the ways to take charge of your association is to what? Is the fact that at this time, widows rely less on others to take charge of their decision. So when you are taking your decision, please, as we always know, don't take it when you are too happy. Don't take it when you are too sad. Don't take it when you are mourning. Just look for if it's something you are not grounded in, if it's something you cannot take charge of, look for a professional. Take professional advice. Look for experienced people. That is one way to take charge of your association. Another way to take charge of your association is that you should not live with any kind of negativity. Don't. Like as Lady Hope said, your circle of friends. Look at your circle of influences. Identify the kind of people that will make you flourish, that will flourish the environment you are. That is one way to take. Not every Dick and Harry that should come to you and tell you things and you want to ruminate over it. No. Take charge of your association. I would say, frankly, it's not yet time to start going from one party to the other. Let's come to practical. Buying one Ashobi to the other. When you have things to do. Also, priorities matters. One of the effective ways of taking charge of your association, if they know you for who you are, she doesn't do this, she doesn't do this, or she does this, she does, they will respect you. Being a widow does not give you license that you want to be happy and just throw caution to the wind. Okay. Then another thing is, as I said, settle for a few major priorities. Everybody have their priorities, so, and everybody knows what makes them heal faster. Look for your own in you. Everybody knows that for widows that have children, their children are their priorities. If we tell so many stories, just find at the end of it all, we live for our children. Make your priorities, but it's not a do or die. What you can afford, you do for your children. What you cannot afford, explain to them. They will understand. Don't compare. Don't compare yourself with one widow that the husband left so much. Don't compare yourself with one widow that is beautiful. Don't just be yourself. Be yourself. That's one way. That's another way to take charge of your association. Be yourself at every point in time. Be the woman you are. Be the man you are. And people, you attract good people. You attract like minds. But if you are jumping from one place to the other, not forgiving, negativity is there. You attract those things. At least there's law of attraction. So taking charge of your association. Know who you are. Identify people that will make you flourish in your environment, in the sphere of widowhood. Ask yourself what you really want. Seek for professional advice or experienced advice, because that's the only way. So you will not fall into different mistakes that people have made. And I know we have learned something there. Though we didn't have anybody from the comment line, but I know on our Facebook, one or two comments are there. Widowhood 101. Take charge of your association. It's been a beautiful discussion with you out there. And I will tell widows out there, take charge of your association. We'll pull through. God bless us and enjoy a great evening. Thank you.
Tell them all the music they play is jam.
It's on hit. It's the bomb.
It's the bomb, baby.
The best, baby.
We're bringing it to you live.
Women Radio.
1.7.